But it is Amanda Arpita, and today in this video we'll be seeing how we can implement the fifth experiment in our Unix lab. And to go to the folder, it is in my main Unix directory, so I say ls. So here we find the experiment 5 p.sh. So first I'll be showing you how the operation is, and then I'll be showing what has to be given inside the program to implement that. So I say to execute this, I give a line called sh space exp5p.sh. So when I give this, it is giving me few choices. So the few choices are, the first one is to be how many words are in the file. So to see that, I give one. So I want to search for the word yo, but actually there is no word called yo over here. So it is giving me there are zero words called yo. So if you want to search for another word like am, I am getting into this program by saying, I made a switch to this. So I get into this program. As you can see, in the first case, if user chooses one, the control will be coming here, and he'll be searching for the word yo. So instead of that, I'll change this to am, because the user would like to search for am right now. And I'm going to save it like this. And I am going to clear the screen first so that it will be visible. And now I would like to execute it again. So as you can see, it is saying the number of words. Okay, that there was a mistake in not editing the print statement. So it is very simple to edit the print statement. I go in here, I come into the insert mode. I say if you're finding the word am, and then I try to execute this again. So it is telling the number of words in am are 2. So now I clear the screen again to show you the second output. So I say the second one. And second one, before the replacement, it was I am Manta Arpita, I am in Karunya. And after replacement, it is going to be I am Danda Arpita, I am in Karunya. Here, to see how the implementation has gone, we're getting inside this folder. And as you can see, in the second case, first we say before replacement, and I display what is in cat find out what. I'm going to do the replacement and find out word.txt. So there is something called sed-i, and I see in this, I want to replace the word Manda. This Manda, I have replaced it with the word Danda in the file.txt. So after replacement, it will again display this file word.txt. So that is why I was getting Danda, I am Danda Arpita. So once this is done, we will go back and we'll be executing this again for the fourth command. I think it is the third command. So there is some error. We'll go and rectify that. File, I think it is find word.txt. There is this mark over here, so I'll be deleting it. Now we try to execute the same command again. I say 3. Okay, so it is giving me file information, the inode number, the link count, the user ID, the group ID, and the size of the file. So to see how that has been implemented, I have just took the file find.words and I did ls-l. This gives me this kind of output in a very big string, and I've stored that in a file called experiment5.txt. And after I have stored it, I'm going to cut it based on each word length and put it over here, because the first character is this, the second character is this, stuff like that. So done with this, I am coming to the next step, which is going to be getting the information of the user logged in. This is actually, when you type foo, you get the same output. I'm going to actually store what is in foo to this file and output this file. So to see that, I'll show the fourth and fifth experiment together. So the fifth one is, you can enter a valid field in this /etc/password. So when you say NTP, there are details about it coming on the screen. That is the username, password, owner ID, comment field is nothing, and the home directory and the user shell is going to be displayed on the screen. So I'll be showing how this has been implemented inside our code. So that I say vi space, and I give in the edit mode, I come here. So as you can see, the field has been entered, and I say grep $r /etc/password, and I save that into etcc.txt. So everything in this file for the particular name which you have entered is getting stored in this, and you cut it based on this lens 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I can say the first field in the text is going to be username, the second field is password ID, and all these follow respectively. So I've shown this, and the fourth one I've not shown you. The user.txt already contains the details, so I'm just going to say cat user.txt. This is how my fifth experiment works. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in another video with another tutorial. Thank you.